One of the most time-consuming parts of creating video content is editing. Now, whether you are a no-tech person, or you have very minimal time on your hands to edit, or to sometimes think editing is the one thing holding you back from creating video content, stick around because in this video, I'm gonna break down how to use iMovie really easily so you can start editing those videos and get your awesome video content out there. Hi, my name is Trina. If you are new here and on this channel, I help creative entrepreneurs just like you figure out how to start using YouTube in your business strategy. Now, to start using video content, you probably got to start editing, right? So I wanted to make sure you knew how to use iMovie as quickly and easy as possible so editing no longer becomes your big bottleneck in this process. So let's jump over to my computer so I can show you some quick tips to make this process so much easier. When you open up iMovie, this is what you're going to see. What you want to do is create new, so go ahead and hit that plus, and you want to create a movie, not a trailer, so make sure you click movie, and then you can start dragging in your video clips. So what you want to do up here is import, and it depends on where your files are. Right now, I don't have a card or a thumb drive plugged into my computer, but if I did, this is what will happen, because I'll plug one in right now, because I shoot on my camera, and I have a camera card. So I just plugged in my camera card to my computer, and now I have this option right here. And I can pull any videos from here that I want to edit. So let's say I'm going to edit this video. I just click it, import. Now I recorded my audio separately, so I've got to pull that off of my computer. So what I want to do now is go down back to import, and I want to go to my desktop. And the file name for this is Boss Project. And you see it's just a audio file. There's no video to it. So I'm gonna go ahead and import. Some other things that I wanna add is some B-roll and some stock footage. So that's all on my desktop as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and import. And you can import these at multiple times. So I want to add this GIF and let's say this B-roll. And I think there should be this photo. Let's say we're gonna add that photo and import it all. Those lines will tell you when it's imported. So you first wanna start with your video. So go ahead, click it, hold the mouse down and drag it down here. Now this is awfully tiny. So what you wanna do on your computer is hit Command plus to make it bigger. And then you also want to bring your audio file down. So go ahead and highlight that and drag it down here. Now, since my audio and video file are separate, I need to sync them. So I'm going to go ahead and hit Command minus to sync these up. You'll see that I clapped there because I'm going to sync that with the clap I did right here in the audio file. So what I'm going to do is get these little arrows. I just have my mouse hovered right there. I'm going to hold down and trim all of this to that spike. And to sync it, I need these two lines to line up. So I'm going to go ahead and Command plus because it's going to help me line it up. And what I do is I have my little bar here, line it up and drag this. Now if it won't drag, it's because you need to cut some. So what I'm going to do is click here and hit Command B for blade and just click that and delete. Bring my bar back over here, line these up, and just listen to see if the clap goes together. Now if it didn't go together, say it was slightly this way, you'll hear two claps. All right, so that's why you want to line this bar up and slide them together like that. Then what you can do is make this a little bit smaller again and start editing. So let's say this is the beginning of the video. What I'm going to do is hit Command B, that is blade that cuts it. And then I'm gonna do Command B for the audio as well. I'm gonna highlight that by clicking it and hit delete. So now my audio and my video are synced together.
Statistics show that 20%.
Now I wanna add, let's say this is where I wanna add some B-roll. I'm talking.
In this video,
And I wanna add this GIF as B-roll over top. So I just click it, hold it down, add it on top of here. And now when I'm talking, I'm gonna have additional footage over top of me talking like this.
Video, I'm gonna tell you exactly how to avoid that thing.
All right, like that. Now let's say you wanted to add a photo and
statistics show.
I wanna add this photo right here. And I can make this as long as I want it. Let's say I want to make it 6 seconds long. Click on that photo and you can go up here and crop it if you want. I want to crop it to fit. So now it looks like this.
Statistics show that 20% of small...
If I don't like that, go ahead and hit it. Go up to crop again. And let's say I want it to Ken Burns. What that means is going to give you that zoom in type feeling. So it's going to start here and end. So let's say, okay, we want to do that. Hit enter. And you can see.
Statistics show that 20% of small businesses fail in their first year.
You can see how it's zooming in. I'm going to grab another photo to show you a great example of this as well. All right, so I pulled in this image right here. And I'm going to go up here. And right now it's Ken Burns. Let's say I wanted to start zoomed in. Let's say we wanted to zoom in. And we wanted to end out here. Okay, so it makes it look like it's motion. So then what you have.
So I want to help you make sure.
You see how that makes it look like B-roll even though it is a photo. So that's how I'm adding these clips in. If you want to add text, say we want a call out point right here, you can go here to titles. And these are all the titles that iMovie has. I actually did a video last week on how to add custom text if you want to check that out. But this one shows you how the text comes out. You can go here and see which one you like. I want to add my name here at the beginning. So since I say my name there, I'm going to go ahead and add this title. And how you change it is you just click here. I'm going to say Trina Little and YouTube Strategist. I want it to be a different font. iMovie has some fonts, so one of my fonts, let's just say we do Chalk Duster, and I want this to be just a little bit smaller because it's not fitting on one line. And if you want to change the color, you can click here, and if you want to add your colors, go to this color wheel, and then you can add your colors in here and save them. So now,
my name is Trina, and on this channel, I help create.
And if I wanted to even go longer, I can drag this, pull it so it goes longer, or drag it so it goes shorter. Now, I'm going to cut out this clip right here since it's not, I'm not talking right there. Go ahead and clip. I'm doing Command-B. Command-B. And then I'm clicking on it and hitting Delete. And you just want to make sure you don't delete your audio. If you do and you make a mistake like that, just go up to Edit, Undo. And so let's just go ahead and delete that. I think that just needs to be there. And so you want to add a transition. Here are the different transitions that you can add into your videos. Don't use too many of these because it just starts to get too cluttered. So I want to do a cross blur. Go ahead and click it, drag it down. And so then this is what it looks like.
Business as well. Hi, my name is Trina.
See, or if you don't want that, go ahead and delete it. Maybe we want it to doorway and stick that in here.
Business as well. Hi, my name is Trina.
So that's how you can add transitions, and they're all up here. Backgrounds, I don't think you necessarily need them unless you want one of these plain ones, but if you watch my custom tutorial, that's probably more specific to you. If you're looking for some sound effects, iMovie has them in here. So you go to audio and you can go to sound effects. There's all different types of sound effects that you can think of in here, like a cartoon accent. So you can go ahead, say you want to add that. When my name pops out, I'm just going to add it right on top, right here. So now it sounds like this.
You can do that for your business as well. Hi, my name is Trina, and on this channel...
Just something to play around with. If you have a call-out text pop up and you want a ding, you can search here for a ding maybe. And just kind of listen to see what you can find. Now you can do iTunes music here, but don't, because you don't want to be hit for copyright infringement. If you want to use music in your video, I would use the YouTube music library where it's all copyright free. Now, once you have your video totally completed, so you go through here and you do Command B to cut, Command B, we're going through here and Command B and deleting all this out, and you're ready to export it. What you want to do is go up here to this little arrow to share. And you want to share it as a file. You don't want to upload it to any of these. You want to hit file, give it a name, My Awesome Movie, and then hit next. and decide where you want to save it, if you want to save it to your desktop, and hit save. Now, if you're ready to up your editing game, make sure you click that video that's on your screen right now that shows you how to make custom text and use your own branded colors in iMovie. Don't forget to subscribe, and thank you so much for watching.